Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. I'm just looking forward to before I start the video, but in today's video I'm going to share with you businesses you can start with 500 Ugandan shillings as your startup capital if you want to start up a side hustle business, mainly with a small amount of income. So let me get where to sit, then we get started. I'll be right back. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. I'm Bibi Olivia and I upload videos concerning agriculture, business, lifestyle and travel. In case you're new in this channel, consider subscribing, like, comment and share. I will appreciate that. So in today's video, as I told you, I'm going to share with you businesses you can start with 500k Ugandan shillings as your startup capital. I would say it is not the main business where you're going to focus. It's not the main business where you can focus for your main source of income. This business, as I'm going to share with you, is like after your work, you can do it in a leisure time, you can do it, or you can use someone to do it for you. But they are really, really profitable and you can get something out of that. As you know, the economy, let me say the African economy, where teachers workers, more so government workers, by the time they are paid, by the time they get their monthly salary, it ends in debts. In the process, in between the month, people borrow for their necessities, for their basic needs. By the time they get their money, it just goes off. You cannot get anything out of that. But if you have your side hustle business, it can bring you the daily income where you can get money and buy things at home. So in today's video, I'm simply sharing with you those type of businesses. Hope you learn something out of it. I can't wait to share with you. Not forgetting, this is kombucha, number one tea drink. We have our company just near home, just there. It's where the company is. To start with the points, I will start with photocopying and printing. Photocopying and printing is a business which works more near schools and offices, more so maybe at the district. All what you need is to buy the photocopying machine, which I'm sure it is less than 500,000 Ugandan shillings. So you have to buy the photocopying machine, one ream of paper, and you have to open up an email where you can give out your customers, your clients. They can easily send the work you're printing to the email. Then you have to offer delivering services. You have to deliver to them. You can start maybe with your workmates if you're a worker, if you're already working. If you're a student, you can start with your fellow students. They have work to print out. They have so many things they print out. So you start as slowly by slowly. You can do it at home, so long as you have electricity at home, that's all. If you have the money more than 500 Ugandan shillings, you can begin with, you can rent. But as a startup, remember we are doing a side hustle business. It's something which can bring income, an extra income on top of what you earn per month. So that's a huge business to start up. Hope you like it. Then cancer. My number two business idea is selling fruits and dressing. Here all what you need is to make sure of the proper hygiene. That's the number one point. Number two point, you have to look for fruits with which are good quality. You have to maintain the quality of the fruits, pest free. So if you go to the market, if you're buying those fruits in the market, make sure you're buying the best fruits. If not, reach home and sort out them. Sort out the good ones and the bad ones, leave aside. The second thing is you have to be with the refrigerator. By the way, you can do this business at home. If you want, you can rent. But now I'm talking about 500 Ugandan shillings. So you're doing it at home. The labeling, the quality, the labeling. When you're labeling the fruits, you make sure the label is clear. For example, we have a company just here at home which makes the kombucha energy tea drink. As you see the label is so clear, the description of what we use and the seal on the bottle, it is so clear. So you can do it. These plastic bottles are so cheap. They are cheap. You can buy it and make it by your own, then you supply your fruits in shops and supermarkets if you want to do it as a supply thing. Another thing you have to know, when you're making those fruits, don't put too much, don't put water at all. Blend those fruits with water free, no sugar. Just make it natural with that quality. Maybe another thing I'm forgetting about fruits is what the refrigerator you have to, if you're supplying to people, you have to put you have to make sure of the coolness. Some, when you're supplying to people, when you're supplying to shops or supermarkets, you don't need the fridge. Don't put sugar in the fruits. That's the main quality. And always target hot climate, like hot weather. When it is hot, you get more customers. When it is cold, obvious case, when it is rainy seasons, no one will buy your stuffs. Another thing you need on fruiting, on fruit selling and juicing, you have to buy the blender. As per now, you can get a blender at 50k or 80k, the best one, 80k. Maybe if you have the money, but this one is beyond 500 Southern Ugandan shillings, you can buy the juice extractor. But that one is more expensive. So as someone who is starting up, buy a blender. Make sure you're sieving those fruits very well. If it is juice, sieve it with quality. Like, be so clean when you're doing that job, you'll get customers. My number three business is to start up. That's my third business idea, is to start up ice cream selling. Ice cream selling is so much easier if you know how to make that ice cream. I will not go into detail about making ice cream. Maybe I will do another video about it. But all what you need is to target places which are busy places, hot days, maybe schools, churches. You have to make sure you have the good packaging, like you have the packaging bags. You have to, what else is needed on ice cream selling? I think all that, the cooler box and the fridge. That's more important on ice cream selling. Lastly, I will end up with snacks and tea selling. This business works more in the evening. If you get a place, maybe if you're staying in the town, after work in the evening, you can pull out your charcoal stove, prepare tea, or you can prepare it at home, then you put in the flask. You go and sell it with snacks. You can start with popcorn, a popcorn machine. If you want to buy it, it's a 3,500 Ugandan shilling, 350k. So you can buy the popcorn machine. Tea is just water. It is not as costly as such. So you buy the water and you start up the business for snacks and tea selling. Maybe you have to buy the plastic bags, the plastic cups where you can supply your tea from. Don't use the real cups, that may be costly. Buy the plastic ones and you package your things. You can decide to package the popcorns very well. You pack them very well, then you sell in the evening. It's a profitable business. What I will end with it, if you want to start something small, don't listen to anyone. Do it as you start, as you, small by small, it will get and it will develop, and you end up in a big enterprise, you end up in a big hotel, you end up in a photocopying and printing machine which is big. I've seen so many people who start small and they end up big. You start as a side hustle business, but put your focus there. Slowly by slowly, it will develop and it will grow up. That was it for today. I love you so much. Consider subscribing in case you're new on this channel. To my old subscribers, I really appreciate. May God bless you. Bye-bye.